Good morning, respected principal, teachers, and my dear friends. Today, I, Gautam Krishna, is standing before you to say some words concerned with the National Library Week celebration. We celebrate National Library Week from 14th November to 21st November. First of all, let us hear some words about Sri S.R. Ranganathan. Shyali Ramamrita Ranganathan was a mathematician and a librarian from India. He was a university librarian and a professor of library science at the Banaras University and the University of Delhi. He is considered as the father of library science, documentation and information science in India. One of his most notable work is his Five Laws of Library Science. Library plays a vital role in the social, intellectual and academic development of a child. Reading helps us to expand our mind, improves concentration and helps in our vocabulary. Overall, it is said that reading can change our life for the better. I conclude by requesting all of you to read.
Hi everyone, Aparna Jit here. Hope all of you are doing good. And today I am here to review my most favorite book, which is also one among the very famous series, The Famous Five, by the eminent children's author Enid Mady Blyton. This book is of adventure genre, for which Enid Blyton is particularly famous. My desired book is The Famous Five's Five Go Off in a Caravan. The book is about four kids and a dog who always end up solving a very mysterious adventure. The Famous Five, who are Julian, Dick, Georgina, Anne, and Timothy, the dog, go off in a caravan and then find a circus troupe. Soon, the five find out that they are in for a thrill. They start to investigate, gather clues, solve mysteries for which they had to travel through passages, dark caves, and even through water holes, giving the reader a thrilling experience all throughout the book. The author has a unique and intelligent way of plotting her stories. I love reading books of Enid Blyton because her books are very fascinating and exciting to read. Having said that,
good morning, I am Srihiri Vijay of Class 6C, and today I am going to present a book review about the book that goes from my father to his daughter. This cannot be thought of as a book but a collection of letters. These letters were written by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru to his beloved daughter Srimati Indira Gandhi during the summer of 1928, when Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was busy working in Allahabad and Indira Gandhi was in Mussoorie spending her vacations in fun. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru thought that Indira Gandhi may feel bored, so he decided to send a series of letters about how and when the earth was made, how civilization started, how kings came, and so on. Thank you.
My name is Indrajit Sinaya and I am from Class 8. Today I am going to present a short book review on Geronimo Stilton, The Treasure of Israel. Author Elisabetha Daniel. Geronimo works as a reporter in Providence, Dublin at university. Geronimo at work and he receives a mysterious letter along with the map of Israel from his sister Gia. The map contains a riddle that mentions about the biggest apple and the 15 productors, the 7 young explorers and the big black bubble. Geronimo, who was a bit timid, does not want to really go to Israel, but he is afraid his sister Gia is in danger. So he agrees to go to help her along with his cousin, a photographer from his cousin and an archaeologist. After they reached the Israel, they met a guy named Vidya. The next morning, Vidya understood that they are much more than a typical tourist group. Geronimo informs her that they have actually came here to try and find out his sister Tia.
Namaskar. Kya samay bitne ke saath saath har kshetr mein badlav hote hain? Dak darbari hum padhenge to hame lagenge nahi. Dak darbari mane Hindi ke mahan sahityakar श्रीला शुक्ल जी के द्वारा 52 वर्ष पहले लिखे गए हिंदी साहित्य के कालजयी उपन्यासों में से एक है, जिसकी प्रासंगिकता आज भी है। कारण वो उपन्यास पढ़ने के बाद हमें लगेंगे कि ये सिर्फ कहानी नहीं है, हमारे भारतीय समाज ही है, हमारे भारतीय समाज के दर्पण है। कारण सालों पहले हमारे समाज में फैले भ्रष्टाचार, अराजकता, सत्ता, अधिकार, इन सभी के नामों पर होने वाले पाखंडता आज भी हमें नजर आते हैं। हाँ, आंचलिकता जरूर है, उत्तर प्रदेश के एक गांव के लोगों की कहानी है, लेकिन भारतीय समाज से ये अलग नहीं है। इसके कारण ही उनकी पहली रचना होने के नाते एक साल बाद साहित्य अकादमी पुरस्कार भी मिल चुके हैं और 1985 के बाद दूरदर्शन में धारावाहिक के रूप में भी इसके प्रसिद्धि और भी बढ़ गई है। डाक दरबारी के अनुसार व्यवस्था पर इतने अधिक घोर आक्रमण हुआ है कि आज भी रबर स्टैंप के तरह रहने वाले लोगों के ऊपर उपहास किए गए हैं। ये एक व्यंग्यात्मक उपन्यास नहीं है, लेकिन हाँ, हास्य तो किए हैं। हास्य हमारे व्यवस्था के ऊपर हुए हैं, व्यवस्था जो सब लोग बदलना चाहते हैं। सब लोग हमारी व्यवस्था पर कोसते हैं, लेकिन हम नहीं बदलेंगे तो हमारी व्यवस्था कैसे बदले। इसलिए जरूर पढ़िए राग दरबारी।
कैप्टन का रेंजर्स में रडयार्ड किपलिंग। रडयार्ड किपलिंग वाज अ फेमस इंग्लिश फिलोसोफर, शॉर्ट स्टोरी राइटर, नॉवेलिस्ट एंड अ पोएट। बोर्न इन इंडिया, हिज मोस्ट फेमस वर्क वाज अ जंगल बुक। द बुक कैप्टन करेजियस टेल्स द स्टोरी ऑफ अ स्पॉइल्ड सन ऑफ अ रेलवे मैग्नेट हु इज थ्रोन ऑफ द स्टीमबोट व्हिच इज ऑन इट्स वे टू यूरोप। द फादर ऑफ द चाइल्ड इज सो एनॉयड विद द स्पॉइल्ड ब्रैट दैट ही वांट्स हिम ऑफ बोर्ड। The rejection changes a boy's life. The story focuses on the personal transformation from a pampered, arrogant son of a millionaire to an admirable young man. It's a moving story and a must read for all teenagers who are filled with adventure and anxiety.
Hi everyone. Books can be our greatest companion at any time. As a part of National Library Week celebration in our Vidyalaya, I would like to suggest a good book for you to read. Sir, now it's indeed a book worth reading for every student and every teacher at any stage of their life to understand how they influence each other's life. To Sir with Love is a story written by Mr. E. R. Braithwaite. It is an autobiographical novel and is set in the East End of London. It also gives glimpse of social discrimination as the author faced to find a suitable job in spite of his high educational qualification and ends up taking a teaching job in London. He was surrounded by indisciplined and unmotivated children. Children were quite rude to him. They played pranks. But he didn't give up. He changed his strategy of teaching. He treated them with respect. He tried to impart life skills to them. He considered them as his equals and prepared them to face the life. Children also slowly responded positively. It's also quite touching to see that how children adore and respect a teacher who made them realize their own worth.
Dressed the hunter from the fairy tale Little Red Riding Hood.